All right, one more video regarding the election. Thank goodness we have won and democracy has been saved. And I just want to further back up the power of education and emotional IQ in the United States. If you look demographically at the United States, the East Coast, the West Coast are full of progressive educated thinkers, while rural America, even in the on the East Coast and West Coast, are not educated and progressive for the most part in their thinking. And in the Midwest and the South, you just have fewer college grads. And the people who do graduate from college in the South and the Midwest oftentimes end up on the West Coast or the East Coast, which are blue, democratic, progressive thinking areas. So demographically, the education, emotional IQ issue is very apparent. And until we can educate rural America, and increase their emotional IQ, we simply are stuck with this unfair electoral college system, even though Biden and Harris won 4 million more votes in the popular vote. We're still stuck with this corrupt, or I should say, just unfair electoral college system for the time being, which gives these uneducated areas too much power, similar to the Senate. Having too much power in these rural, uneducated areas. I've been to many rural areas throughout the country, and I'll go through an area on my bicycle, for instance, in the mountains, and there'll be gun-toting, uneducated hicks out there shooting their guns, and I have to literally, go by them and then risk my life. And then they feel tough, of course, because they have a gun. And that has happened to me many times out in rural areas when I'm biking long distance. And that's what we're stuck with in America for the time being. And the East Coast, West Coast, and the educated people congregating there have saved the democracy in the United States with this election. That's my last comment regarding education and emotional IQ and how that leads to progressive thinking and higher emotional IQ and such. Goodbye.